And Paulsa, Brayton Paulsa scampers, and I'm not sure why he passed the ball there, because it looked like he had a clean run to the line. And now it's Eloy Smealy who gathers it for Georgia. Well, I'd like to see that again, to see exactly why Paulsa made that decision at that time. As Jim Shalagi clears, and Jim Shalagi again misses touch, and his forwards are not going to thank him for that. Here's Werner Grief. Big overlap wide. Pretty good pass too. Stefan Terblanche trying to straighten things up. Tackle coming in from Herner Lidze. An African advantage. Here's to Koch. Puchat. Near Kirk. Paulsa. It's forward, but the referee brings them back for a penalty. And Schultz is halfway through his sin bin spell. The referee again, Stuart Dickinson, is going to have a word.
Just too high, Maddock, as you step back in. You're off. It's good, man.
Decision time for South Africa. They're going for the touchline rather than the penalty.
Georg Gadze, the man who was spoken to there, is Derek Kuchart. It's touch, and that's the reason why the penalty was given.
The Brayton Paulsa, as you say, I thought he had the line in his mercy. He passed, I mean, didn't look to. Well, he passed to a Georgian player for a start.
Taken by Bota. Stefan Terblanche coming in off the wing. Russell going for a hat-trick of tries. 8 metres short. De Kock. Mudurbadze, the referee again, is playing an advantage. Puchat. Good little chip, that, wasn't it? Good little chip. The referee wants to have a look. It was Jacques Fleury taking the timeout. Alan Lewis on the far side, he wasn't 100% sure.
Touch and goal. Thank you, you've got that touch and grounding.
Well, Alan Lewis has just said to the referee, he thinks he's okay. We'll make a decision, Mr. Lewis. That's what you're there for. I think it's try time myself. No wrong with that at all. Alan Lewis could have seen that quite comfortably. I don't know why we're going up to the TV official, the video ref as they call it, but we are upstairs. Alan Lewis is perfectly positioned, I have to say.
The only doubt might be if his right elbow was on the whitewash. No, I got to try.
Not a doubt, wasn't there? Come on, you know what the result is. I don't know, again, as I say, Alan Lewis is spot on.
Downward pressure before his right elbow was anywhere near the white line. There's the free scrim we were waiting for. And Derek Puchart's already preparing to take the conversion, so he's pretty confident.
Can't believe they have made the decision. Why are they seeing another replay? I've got no idea at all. That admittedly looks close to the elbow, but the front-on replay shows clearly this is the one. This is the one to look at. Watch the ball. Forget the elbow. Watch the ball. It's on the ground now. It's a try. Let's get on with it.
Joël Dumais is the television official.
After all that, he'll probably give a 5-yard scrum.
You got a decision? Okay, one more.
He wants another one, another replay. He wants the shot from the helicopter.
Well, this isn't going to tell him. That is the worst angle to look at it from, because you can't see the line parallel with the ball or the hand. That's a useless angle. This is the angle. This is the only angle to see it from. Ball's down now. That's downward pressure.
You there, Joel? Okay, so. It is a try, okay? We're right to give the decision. Okay. Time back on.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Why are you not the television official, Jimmy? Because you're very good at it.
Well, it is. Pretty simple. Well, I had a pop at Alan Lewis for not making the decision himself. He's right there. That was the only angle to look at it from. No other angle was relevant in my book. Good little kick. Let's get back to why the try was scored. It was a good little kick through from
it was.
How hard?
Well, that took 2.5 minutes. 2.5 minutes that decision. I mean, it's great if you're the Georgian front row, but not for the crowd or anybody else, is it?
Yeah. I think what we're going to find, though, is that the Georgians not going to be helped by a yellow card soon, because they have certainly transgressed in that area.
Conversion is successful. ITV's huge World Cup weekend just keeps coming, of course. Don't forget Sunday, ITV1 from 7 a.m. Oh, we've seen this enough. The crucial match which may decide second place in Pool A, the Argentinians against Keith Wood's Irish Marauders. I'll be in Adelaide with Jamie Salmon for that. And that's followed on ITV1 at 9:30 by the Pool C dogfight between England's pride and the dangerous physical Samoans. All coming up exclusively live from your home of the 2003 Rugby World Cup, ITV. And the website, of course, itv.com/RWC.
And as you saw, another wonderful restart by South Africa. Let the ball bounce, point one, then got offside.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable. A restart, there's just no excuse for that at all. None whatsoever. Quite appalling.
Ker Viri Kashvili, a 19-year-old student, is on. He's the youngest player in the Georgian squad with the longest name. Again, that they're at least they're trying to work moves in the line-out. They know they've got problems to the tail. It's been a bit scrappy there. So Dundashvili, who the try scored, didn't go five, but, you know, a little bit of variety. And I think he realised he's got to maybe keep it short or shorter.
Yeah, but Skulks are still off the field. I'd have just repeated what they did to get the try. There he is again.
Good lad. He's just an anagram, that fella. Another replacement coming on, Kamazaridze, who, again, if you have watched the Sevens series on ITV, you'll have seen him play, and he's a good Sevens operator. 30 caps for his country at 15s. Well, Georgia managing to come up with that one through Chikadze. They've set it well, too. Dundashvili goes in to clear it out for Modarbadze. They've got two thumping great centres, huge guys, Ilosvili and Katsat. Kamazaridze's a big guy too, and trying to dart his way through is Kerviri Kashviri. South African down injured, so an extra man for Georgia if they can take advantage of it. Katsadze, Modarbadze. And this is Dundashvili, a try scorer. Oh, he was bounced hard by Rotenbach. Modarbadze, South African player, looked to me as it was in the way between the scrum half and the out half. Stuart Dickinson is going to give the penalty to Georgia. There were at least two infringements there, but I think the first one was for getting between.
Yeah. Please go back.
Yeah, Lizzie, yeah. Thank you, Stuart.
Going for goal, racking up the points.
Lawrence Opaka, blood injury. They've got two props on the bench. South Africa, Dale Sampton and Christo Besaidenhout. Who started against England. Taking over the kicking duties in the absence of Jim Shaladze is the 19-year-old wine-making student. Skydiver in his spare time. Mirak Kerviri Kashvili. And he parachutes Georgia up to 19 points, and it's 36-19. It's a very respectable performance, a very respectable scoreline for the man from Georgia.
It most certainly is, as South Africa, I think, are beginning to ring the changes as well. Skulks has come back on from the sin bin.
Joe van Neerkerk is replaced as well. Now, another dreadful restart, really is pandemonium on both sides of the restart.
actually, even though there was that pandemonium, Mudder Badji had plenty of time. Coming on to replace Van Niekerk is Skalk Berger, whose father played for the Springboks, huge man that he was. And Skalk Berger makes his debut for his country. And Joel Stransky was telling me he's a man to watch for the future, is going to be a real talent. That's Fjordi Loebschaar, hit hard, very hard by Hörner Lidze. De Kock, Hohart. It's Rosso in midfield again. And Schmidt gets support from Bakis Buta.
I think Bakis Buta just left a little reminder there. And that's what the crowd's reacting to.
Well, it was Kaviri Kashvili. And he's tiny too. Not the sort of guy you want to see thumped by a fella as big as Bakis Buta.
Bit unlucky when you're off the pitch as well. I thought the touch judge might have done something about that. Can South Africa do something from a set piece?
John Schmidt. That's great. Well, there's a lot of work to do on the Springbok camp. It is, yeah, it's the second 15, we know that. But it has been a thoroughly disheartening display all round by them. On the squeeze, the second drive coming on, here's Berger. Good well, Berger, strong man, De Kock, Hohart, need to miss players out here. Oh, the interception, almost from Kavtaresvili. Oh, well, he's speaking pure Kertuli there, the 33-word Georgian alphabet, and I'm sure the language wasn't sweet.
I can't believe this move. The Georgian wingers have always come in for the extra man and left the last man alone. They always do that. They've done it all night, and yet the South Africans haven't spotted it. So what's the point of doing a missed pass to the fullback when the left winger is going to come in for him? It's just beggars belief at times. It's just somebody out there has not got the vision.
Berger, De Kock, Loebschaar. Good tackle from Mudder Badji and a knock forward.
The defensive pattern they're running basically means the left winger will come in for the fullback, leaving the South African right winger free on a one-on-one with the Georgian fullback. That's just their defensive pattern. Fine, no problem. Everybody knows where they stand. But South Africa, and Loebschaar in particular, keeps getting clobbered.
Well, the Georgians are finding that particular move very easy to defend against. In touch there is Victor Ndidi Bolidze from Valence in France, and a few problems on the floor. Already had an incident off the pitch involving Bakis Buta.
I think it's the debutant, Scott Berger, who was involved there. Bakis Buta there as well.
Referee calling a timeout. Attempts to get to the root of the problem. Might see what happened. Here's Berger with Didi Bolidze.
It's been good so far. You're new on. I know you're keen, but let's not be silly. Okay? Just calm down. Okay? We'll just play the game.
Too bad.
Okay. All right. Don't pull him. Grab him. Okay.
You're right, mate. Traditional values, the handshake. Don't see that too often these days after a bit of fisticuffs.
I see a throat shake occasionally.
Scott Berger's father's in the crowd tonight. Proud moment for him.
Rosso. Lost forward advantage to Georgia. I beg your pardon to South Africa, because it was the Georgian defender who actually knocked the ball forward. But again, credit to the Georgian defence. The Springboks are finding it very difficult to break them down.
It's not controlled play by South Africa, though, is it, at all? They're just too loose. There's just no unity there. There's no understanding whatsoever. And it's a backward step this tonight for South Africa in their campaign. And John Bo, the Samoan coach, might be having a... Well, he might have started with coffee, but they'll be having gin and tonic. I mean, what's this for the first 67 minutes?
Yeah, it looks very ad hoc, this performance.